Hi friends, now I am going to explain how can we connect keypad with 8051 microcontroller. I am going to make 4x3 keypad here, so I'll be having 4 rows and 3 columns. So we'll move on to Proteus software. Just take your microcontroller 89C51 from your component mode, just paste it here. First I need to give oscillator circuit. So 18th and 19th pin of your microcontroller is allotted for oscillator circuit. I'm going to use 12 MHz crystal oscillator. So I'm giving connection like this. Just connect your oscillator to 18th and 19th pin. I am going to use capacitors also here. The value of capacitor is 33 picofarad. Since we are having leakage current in oscillator circuit, we are using capacitors here. So one end of the capacitor will be connected to oscillator. Another end of the capacitors will be connected to ground. So take your ground from your terminal mode. Give connection like this. Now I am going to give reset circuit. To give reset circuit, we need a push button as well as 10K resistors. Just connect your switch with your supply. Connect 10K resistor with your push button. 9th pin is your reset pin in your microcontroller. Another end of the resistor is grounded. So connect mediator terminal, that is between switch and resistor, to 9th pin of your microcontroller. Here I am going to use capacitor also between your push button, also from supply. I need to give enable pin to high because we have to enable your microcontroller. 31st pin is your enable pin for your 8051 microcontroller. I am going to connect my keypad in port 0. Your port 0 doesn't have inbuilt pull-up resistors, so we have to connect external pull-up resistor to port 0. So here I have taken external pull-up resistor and I am connecting it to port 0. So your external pull-up resistor will be having 8 resistors inbuiltly and 1 positive pin. Just connect your positive terminal to the positive pin of your pull-up resistors. So now I am going to make a keypad. So here I am going to make 4x3 keypad, that is 4 rows and 3 columns. So give default connection from your port 0. You can get this default connection from terminal mode. So here I am giving default connection for each pin of port 0. So totally I am having 8 connections here. So give connection like this. So give the name for this default connection. So as I told, I'll be getting 4 rows and 3 columns. So I am giving name as R1, R2, R3, R4 and also C1, C2, C3. So now I am going to make keypad. Take a push button from your component mode. So your first row consisting of 3 switch and second row is also consisting of 3 switch. So your rows and all consisting of 3 switch, columns and all consisting of 4 switch. So totally I am having 12 switches here. So now I am going to make a row 1. So take default connection from component mode. I am going to make row 1 connection now. So give the name as R1 here. So with R1 we need to connect one resistors also. Resistor range here I am using is 1K. So I am connecting this default connection with 1K resistor. So just connect all your switches which is connected in first row. So one end of the switch connections will be going to R1. Likewise, we have to make R2, R3, R4. So each row is consisting of resistors with a range of 1K. So take resistor for each rows. Give connection like this. So come to your second row. I'm connecting second row with 1K resistor again. Connect your second row switches. One end of the switches will be connected to second row. Come to third row. Give the name as R3. Already it is connected with 1K resistor. So connect. The switches are connected in R3, no? Just connect all the switches in R3. Come to R4. Connect the switches for R4. So your row connections got over. Now move on to column connection. So all other terminal of the switches are not connected with any of the pins. Now we are going to make a column. So columns also connected with 1K resistors. So take 1K resistor from component mode. Just give it to column. So I am taking 3 resistor for columns also. For column 1, column 2, column 3. So as I told before, all other terminals of the switches are not connected with any of the terminals. So take a default connection. So I am connecting first column now. So just connect switches like this to make a column 1. Give name as C1. Come to column 2. Connect all the switches to make column 2. So take a default connection as I told before. So connect all the switches for column 2. That is another end of the switches are not connected, no? So take all the connections. And connect that with column 2 pin. Then come to column 3. Already we have taken 1K resistor. Just connect from 1K resistor. Connect all the switches. And connect it to column 3. So just give name as column 2 as well as column 3. So now our keypad connections got over. So So another end of the resistor will be going to positive, that is power supply. So I am just connecting all the other end of the resistors, and that connection will be connected to positive, that is power supply. So I am taking power from component mode and I am giving power here. So keypad connections got over for me. Now I am going to use LCD display for getting corresponding output from keypad. So your 16 cross LCD will be having data pins. I am going to connect that data pins with port 2. So I am just selecting port 2 here. So take default connection and connect each default connection with port 2. So give name as D1 because your LCD will be having 8 data pins right from D1 to D8. So I am starting from D1, D2 and so on. So this connection is for data lines for your 16x2 LCD display. So now I am going to give connection for read write, enable and register selection pin. So I am giving name as E for enable, write for read write pin and RS for register selection. So these pins are allocated for enable, read write and register selection for LCD display. So now I am taking 16x2 LCD display from component mode. Already I have connected data lines and also enable read write and register selection pin. So just I am giving default connection for data pins from D0 to D7. In controller I am taking it from D1 to D8, but in LCD it is defined as D0 to D7. So I am connecting data pins like this. Totally we are having 8 data lines. So give name as D1 for D0 because we have taken D1 to D8 for controller. So here also we have to take from D1 to D8. So first pin is D1, second pin is D2 and so on. Till D8 we have to give name as D1, D2, D3, D4, D5, D6, D7 and D8. So now we are giving name for register selection, read write and enable. In controller for enable we gave name as E. So here also we are giving name as E. For read write we gave name as write, here also write, and for register selection RS, so give name as RS here also. So your first pin is connected to ground, so I am taking ground here. So connect your first pin to ground like this. Second pin will be going to power supply. Third pin will be connected to potentiometer. So inside of potentiometer you will be having variable resistor. By adjusting resistor we will be getting brightness in LCD display. So connect common pin of your potentiometer to third pin of your LCD. Just take your Xcode to download for keypad by double clicking your microcontroller. Click OK. Give run button. So you will be getting corresponding output. Your run button will be available at the bottom of your Proteus software. So I am getting corresponding output here. So I am pressing my first switch. I am getting output as 1, second switch output as 2, third switch output as 3, and so on. So till 8 I am getting proper output. So like this we can give keypad connection in Proteus. Thank you for watching this video.